Hi guys, it's Tuesday, it's the 28th of September, which means after today, we have just 2 days left of my September self-sufficiency challenge. And I'm feeling really, really good about it. I obviously spent a lot of time yesterday doing a lot of food prep and it's put me in a really good place. So I'm just enjoying it now. I'm enjoying these last 2 or 3 days and we're getting back to great food and a celebration of self-sufficiency. And we're starting with what I had for tea last night, which is my chicken noodle soup that you saw me make. And it smells great. So it smells great. I had it for tea last night and I'm really looking forward to it now. If you bought that in a restaurant or a cafe, you'd be very, very happy with it. And I am. So I was talking a bit last night, and well, I've been talking quite a bit recently actually on the channel about just the time involved in doing this. So when you think about it, the prep for this meal started at the weekend on Tuesday today, and I think it started on, well, it might have been Friday with a roast chicken dinner, because it was the leftovers from that roast chicken dinner is the chicken in here. And then after that, we've also used that carcass to make that stock, and that stock was a, you know, a day or two's process. And then obviously all the time last night. And you can even trace it back further than that. You know, the sweet corn in here, I probably sowed that in April, maybe May. Same with the jalapenos. You know, we've got carrots in here, all these things that we've grown in our garden. And Nat from the Allotment Kitchen Garden mentioned on one of my recent videos that, you know, it takes a village for self-sufficiency. And it really does, because, you know, even in here, these noodles, it took a relationship with the business that lives next door to us, the bakery, to develop that relationship so we can trade our eggs for the flour that's made this pasta, these egg noodles, call them what you will. So, you know, it's a long process and there's a lot of thought, time, effort and care gone into this spoonful of food, and I can taste it. I can taste it all. And of course, we've got our sourdough with our starter that might be years old. I don't know, it was gifted to me. So where am I going with all this? I don't know really. I suppose I'm just trying to say that you can do as much or as little as you want. And if you choose to do a great deal, the rewards are there, you know? And that's what I'm reaping today. That's not to say it's been easy. And as you guys know, if you've been following me, there have been some days I've really struggled this month, and there's been some real challenges and there's been some real lows. But as I sit here right now, I'm just over the moon and delighted and full of joy and appreciation for this food and where it's come from, even though it's raining. And it's put a real smile on my face. You know, it's a rainy autumnal day here. I'm working really hard and lots of shoveling and, you know, not fun stuff today, but you know, this has really, really put a smile on my face, and it's not making do. I suppose that's what I'm trying to say. Having this for lunch is not making do. A lot of my lunches have been. A lot of my lunches this month have been making do, but this isn't. I'm thoroughly enjoying it. So I'm going to stop talking to you now so I can concentrate on the rest of it and carry on enjoying it. So I'll speak to you guys when I get home. Okay guys, so I've just got home and it's still raining out there. It's pretty wet and I've just milked the goats. So I've done that, I've got my milk to process, but I picked up a pasta maker. So I'm gonna be playing with that in a bit. Gonna use that to roll my pasta because it's a real pain to do it by hand. And it was actually only £20. I think it was £21. So yeah, really happy with it. I'll let you know what I think of it. But while I was out milking the goats, I also noticed a couple more of our sweet corn plants had been blown over. On closer inspection, I'm not sure if they're getting blown over or if they're getting taken down by squirrels climbing up them, because loads of the ears have been eaten. And I'm a bit gutted actually, so I've harvested every single one that we've got left, which isn't as many as it would have been. We've lost about 12. So I'm going to, before I do anything else, going to get a pan of water on. I'm going to cook these and then they can go in the freezer, or well, I'll probably end up eating a couple because they're sweet corn, fresh sweet corn. But yeah, I'm going to get a pan on, get that done. Then I'm going to get out of some of my wet clothes, wash up, give my hands a good clean, and then start making pasta, start making that ravioli.
Right, so I've cooked all of that sweet corn. We've got it in the freezer, the stuff that we're not eating. And I've eaten a couple of cobs, obviously. And I'm all prepped, ready to go. So we have got the pasta maker here, which I haven't used yet. Haven't really worked out how to use, but I'll figure that out in a second. Now, I'm aware I'm filthy, but I have washed my hands and I'm only preparing my own food, but I am clean apart from my face. And yeah, so we're all prepped here. So we've got our pasta dough, which is going to be our ravioli. We've got our spinach, our crayfish tails, our goat's cheese. Those are all going to make up the filling. And I've been umming and ahhing between this cheese sauce that I made 2 or 3 days ago and the tomato sauce, which I made yesterday. And my wife has decided for me, because I couldn't make my mind up, we're going with the cheese sauce. So the tomato sauce is going to stay in the fridge till tomorrow. Definitely got a use for that, don't worry. We're going to have the cheese sauce and we're going to have that just with a salad. And I've got the stuff that I'm making the salad out of over here. Really simple tonight, keeping it simple. I want to be done fairly early. We've got just some lettuce, cucumber and onion from the garden. That is it. That's it, we're done. So I'm going to see if I can work out how to use this pasta machine now. And I will catch up with you guys in a bit when I'm filling the ravioli, I think. So here we go. And I've got my pasta sheets rolled out. I've got to tell you, oh my goodness, the difference this makes. This might be the best machine in the world. If you've got to make pasta, the difference between having this and not having it is night and day. Now, that's not to say that you need it. And if you want to make pasta and you don't have it, do it. Don't let that stop you, because it wouldn't stop me. If you took this machine away from me, I would carry on doing it. So don't let not having one be the reason that you're not making pasta. But if you are going to make pasta and you can afford the £20 or whatever it'll cost where you live, and you can afford the space in your kitchen for it or in your loft for it to go when you're not using it, then it's a fantastic investment. I've only used it to roll these sheets thin, and already just the difference is unbelievable. So anyway, I've got my sheets rolled out, so I'm just going to make up the raviolis now, and it's going to be really quite simple. And we're going to start by just putting a little bit of spinach everywhere that we want to make one of our parcels. Next up, we're going to put a little bit of goat's cheese there. Right, now the tricky bit. I've got to put the other sheet of pasta over the top and press it down all around. Oh, that's okay. That's not too difficult at all. And you want to make sure that you get as much of the air out as you possibly can. The moisture that's in that spinach is going to help to stick it together. This is going well. And then you can get a ravioli cutter, which cuts them and leaves those pretty edges, but I don't have one. So I'm just going to cut it with a knife and then use a fork to form those edges. There we go. There's one of our ravioli parcels. My first ever attempt at anything like this. So far, I'm really happy. I'm going to get on and make the rest now and then going to just boil them, add the sauce, serve it with a salad, and I'll show you the final results, I think. Like an idiot, I forgot to put the crayfish in there. I was getting so carried away with my ravioli that I didn't put any crayfish in those, so I'm not going to make that mistake with this lot. So these are my crayfish tails, and I'm just going to put half of each of these in one of these bits of ravioli. So that's my ravioli. I've got to get a pan on now. So I'm going to get a pan on with some water on, get that heating up. While that's happening, I'm going to roll out some more pasta for tomorrow night, because I've got a plan for that as well. Then I'm going to pack everything up, serve up, and I'll speak to you then. Here it is. I've made actual real life ravioli. Now, I've never even made pasta before a week or two ago. I'm really, really happy with that. I put the leftover crayfish in the sauce, and it's the goat's cheese sauce that we had the other night, and well, I'm really, really happy with it, having not tried it. So let's try a bit. It's really good. I've impressed myself. So we've got spinach and goat's cheese ravioli with crayfish in. So spinach, goat's cheese and crayfish ravioli in a goat's cheese sauce with some salad out the garden, a bit of sourdough, and I am over the moon with how this has turned out. I'm just thrilled. So that's it. That's going to wrap today up. And, you know, so even though I threw this meal together tonight, it goes back to what I was saying at lunchtime. You know, the thought process for this started some time ago. We were trapping these crayfish a few months ago. They've been in the freezer. We've already cooked them, eaten them for a meal. The pasta I made a few days ago, the salad we've been growing for goodness knows how long. You've got the sourdough and the sourdough starter that's been a perpetual thing for some time. And, you know, it's all culminated in this dish. And yeah, I couldn't be happier. Couldn't be happier with it. I haven't added any salt or pepper to it, and it's just right. So there you go. So thanks for watching, everyone, and I will be back tomorrow. Please make sure that you press that like button before you go. Also, leave me a comment, let me know what you think. Let me know if you're gonna make pasta, if you've made it before, if you know what you're doing. Am I doing something wrong if you're gonna give it a go for the first time? And also, please make sure that you are subscribed to my channel if you're not already. Thanks for watching, and I'll speak to you all tomorrow. Cheers.